Well, I was finally able to tie down Mark Canzanetta. You are one busy guy.
I am busy. Thank you, Casey. It's
nice
to see you.
There's been a lot of changes here. You may remember the old Culinary Arts on McClurg Road. Well, now it's Aqua Pazzo.
It is Aqua Pazzo.
And I just love the warmth and the concept.
Well, we built Aqua Pazzo. You know, I had this idea flashing around my head for the last 25 years, all my travels throughout the United States and in the country and the world. And this restaurant always was close to my heart. It just never had the right time to come out of it yet. And to now, last May 7th, it was time for Aqua Pazzo to be born. And that's when we brought it to the Mahoning Valley. And I'm so proud of it, so proud of the people that are around me and my staff, and thankful to Tom Zeiden for helping me bring my dream come true, and Johnny Corey for all the amazing branding. You know, it takes a lot of talented people to make a restaurant like this happen, and we have that.
Why do you think it needed the change from when it was the Culinary Arts Center? Because it was a beautiful room.
Oh, it was absolutely stunning.
And you kept the open kitchen concept.
Yeah, we did keep the open kitchen concept. What we did was we opened it up. I wanted it to be like coming over to Grandma's house on Sunday. So I wanted that warmth and that heartfelt feeling in a place that you create memories at, like you did at Grandma's house, because we always revert to our childhood. So we blew out the wall over here and we added all these beautiful structural beams. And so it feels like now the kitchen is now connected to the dining, to the bar. And that makes it wonderful because now it's like the roar of the crowd and you come here and everybody's talking and having such a great time and laughing and just having great conversations and people are talking to their tables next to them. You know, I wanted it to be, like I said, Grandma's house on Sunday afternoon.
More communal.
Exactly. Communal is the perfect word. One of my favorite restaurants in the United States is the Purple Pig in Chicago.
Yes.
And the only thing I didn't get was my huge communal Last Supper table. Yeah. But we have the Godfather table. Okay. So we have the Godfather
table,
which is great.
We're
at the Godfather table. And, you know, a lot of business is done here with a lot of Valley clients. So it's just a warm restaurant. You feel like you could come every day. Whereas the other one felt like an occasion restaurant.
Yeah, a special occasion and a beautiful room. You know, you felt more Miami Beach.
You did.
Than
and
Youngstown,
that's how it was
Ohio.
Designed. Yeah. And they did a phenomenal job doing that and creating that. The only problem with that was there wasn't an ocean outside. So we still have our
the
roots in Youngstown.
Definitely doesn't work here.
And now here, you know, you come and the food's approachable. You know, there's food from your childhood. There's food from your memory. You know, I was blessed to go over to Rome and all of Italy and see a lot of things over there and taste the taste. And until a chef does that, you can't recreate what is over there, you know. And over there is amazing simplicity in their food.
Well, that's exactly what, when you were designing this menu, I'm glad I love that brick oven.
Thank you.
Because, I mean, that just smokes. I mean, between meats and the pizzas
and everything.
Plus,
you're looking at it right now and it just looks amazing.
It's beautiful and it adds such a warmth to this room. You know, when you were going over the menu selection, what did you know absolutely had to be on this menu?
Well, pizza.
Of course.
And pasta.
And it's delicious.
Pizza and pasta. I mean, you know, two of things that you know for fact are everything about Italy, pizza and pasta. And then you come down to the salumis and the formaggis, the cheeses. But, you know, pasta. We cook every order of pasta to order. We invested about $25,000 in our infrastructure and our pasta area. We have two machines, pasta cooking machines back there, and we cook every order to order. It's all rustichella d'Abruzzo pasta, imported from Italy, 96-hour dry time. It's bronze dye. It's absolutely the best pasta, and we cook it to order for every guest that walks through the door.
And the meats, you're always using, imported Italian
we
meats
are,
and
you know,
cheeses.
We have Prosciutto San Daniele right here. It's 2 years old. It's from the north. It's in the winemaking region of Collio and Friuli. We have some finocchia, and of course we have porchetta, which is like one of the big boys of Italy, you know. You take the pork belly and you wrap it with the loin, and then you roast it with fennel and orange and spices, and it's just amazing. And you know, we have dolce gorgonzola and burrata, and then we have tartufo, which is truffled cheese. So.
And let's not forget Papa Canzanetta.
Yeah, we have, you know,
I mean,
tribute,
you know,
to my dad and his peppers.
Authentic hot peppers.
Yeah, my brother Jeffrey has taken over the business now since my dad's passing. And, you know, I started making hot peppers with my father when I was 6 years old. You know,
you've been in the kitchen quite a long time.
You know, I kicked my mom out of the kitchen when I was about 11. My love of Julia Child and, you know, watching her on television that Saturday afternoon completely changed my life forever.
And of all, you know, you've had been at many restaurants. I know you've had great experiences. We're going to talk about Guy in just a little bit. But of all the types of food that you've, you know, prepared, what is your favorite style?
Italian, of course. you know, based on simplicity, based on food from the heart. As Emeril would say, it's a food of love thing. Mm-hmm. You have to sit there, you have to nurture it, you have to talk to it, you know, you have to watch it cook, yeah. You have to be over it. It's nothing, you know, Italian food you don't want to walk away from. You know, you might want to put your sauce on simmer and walk away and have a glass of wine, but if you're making risotto and things like that, it's one of those things you have to sit there and talk to and watch.
Nurture it.
Exactly.
Yeah. Now, tell me about Guy. I know you spent some time helping him with his operations.
Yeah, I did. You know, I had the very fortunate meeting him back when I was here, when it was the CA restaurant, and we were doing cooking classes here, which were fantastic. You know, and I met Guy back in 2010, and we became fast friends. And I was fortunate enough to work on his production team and, you know, research and development of designing most of his product line. And it really worked out well. And we'd always said, you know, if we can someday, let's work together. You know, and then one day out of the blue, I get a phone call from his handler, his manager, Reed Strathern, and they said, hey, do you want to work for Guy? And I'm like, stop the boat. Where do yeah. I sign up? You know, how do you turn down the number one guy in television? You know, he represents 48% of every ad dollar buy of the Food Network.
What is the number one seller?
Believe it or not, it's our filet.
People still love their beef.
Now we put an they still love their beef. You know, we put an Italian twist on it. We make a Chianti syrup to go with mm-hmm. it. We serve it with pancetta, like big chunks of pancetta, crispy pancetta, and taleggio cheese, which is the Italian's version of brie. So that's our number one seller. But you know, pasta is right there number two. If I took pasta and combined it into one segment, but we have 10 pastas on our menu, it yeah. would be the number one seller. But by definition, on our P-Mix, our product mix, it's always going to be the filet.